Good morning, children. I hope you all are doing well. I'm your maths teacher, Shweta Bajaj. Here, I'm back again with chapter 2, whole numbers. But before starting, please like and subscribe my channel so that you get the video notifications on time. And please don't forget to write your name, class and section in the comment section to mark yourself as present. Now, students, in today's video, we are going to start with our next topic, that is patterns in whole numbers. So let's start. Patterns in whole numbers. So first of all, what is a pattern? A pattern is a sequence where numbers are repeated in a specific way. Some numbers can be shown as a line, some as squares, rectangles or triangles. So we will try to arrange the numbers in elementary shapes made up of dots. Firstly, a line, then a triangle, then a rectangle, and in last a square. So first part, every number can be arranged as a line. The number 2 can be shown as 2 dots, and if I will join these 2 dots, I will get a line. The number 3 can be shown as 3 dots, okay? And if I will join these 3 dots, then what I will get? I will get a line. Same way, number 4 can be shown as 4 dots, and on joining those 4 dots, what I will get? I will get a line, and so on. Now, second part, some numbers can be arranged as triangles. The number 3 can be shown as 3 dots, and 2 dots we will take it at a base, and 1 dot at the top row. Okay, see the next. The number 6 can be shown as these 6 dots. Now observe, these 6 dots, 3 dots are in the base, then 2 dots, and in the top row there is only 1 dot. See, the number of dots will be reduced by 1 if we will start looking from the base. Here 3, then 2, then 1. Okay. So from here we got some important notes, and note number 1 says that the triangle should have its 2 sides equal. Note number 2 says that the number of dots in the rows starting from the bottom row would be like 4, 3, 2, 1, and point number 3 says that the top row should always have 1 dot. So hopefully point number 2 is clear to you. Now point number 3, it says that some numbers can be arranged as rectangles. The number 6 can be shown as 3 dots in the bottom row and 3 dots in the top row. And on joining these dots, what you will get? You will get a rectangle. Same way, the number 8 can be shown as this. 4 dots in the bottom row and 4 dots in the top row, and on joining these dots, what you will get? You will get a rectangle. So hopefully point number 3 is also clear to you. Now next is point number 4. It says that some numbers can be arranged as squares. The number 4 can be shown as 2 dots in the bottom row and 2 dots in the top row. And on joining them, what you will get? You will get a square. The number 9 can be shown as 3 dots in the bottom row, 3 dots in the middle row, and 3 dots in the top row. And on joining this, what we will get? We will get a square. Now, next I have taken is question number 6 of exercise 2D. And question number 6 says that write the next 5 numbers in the following pattern. And the pattern is given like this: 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on. Now, here, if you will observe, in 1, if I will add 3, then I will get 4. And in 4, if I will add 5, then I will get 9. And if in 9, if I will add 7, then I will get 16. So from here, what we are observing that we are adding odd number to the given number to get the next number. So after 7, what is the next odd number we can add here? After 7, the next odd number is 9. So on adding 9 to the 16, we will get 25. Next odd number is 11. On adding 11 to this 25, what we will get? We will get 36. What is the next odd number? Next odd number is 13. So on adding 13 to this 36, what we will get? We will get 49. And what is the next odd number? The next odd number is 15. And on adding 15 to this 49, what I will get? I will get 64. And what is the next odd number? That is 17. So on adding 17 to this 64, what we will get? We will get 81. So hopefully question number 6 is clear to you. Now next I have taken is question number 1. Write the first 8 numbers that can be arranged in dots as triangles. Now students, as we have done in our notes, our first number is 3. And how to arrange 3 in dots as a triangles is like this: 1 in the top row and 2 dots in the bottom row, right? And if you will see the next number is 6. And how to arrange this? 1 in the top row, 2 in the middle rows, and 3 dots in the bottom row. Okay, count them: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, sides, check their sides. In this side, there are 3 dots, and in this side, there are again 3 dots. Now, what is the next number? The next number will be 1 dot in the top row, then 2 dots, then 3 dots, and in the bottom row, we will take 4 dots. And how many numbers? So how many dots are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 is the next number. Now from here, what you are observing? You are observing that in this bottom row, there are 2 dots. In this bottom row, there are 3 dots. In this bottom row, there are 4 dots. So in the next bottom row, we will increase the dots by 5 in the bottom. So the next number will be 15. And what will be the next? In the next, 6 dots will be there in the bottom row. So 15 plus 6 will give us 21. Now again in the next, there will be 7 dots. So 21 plus 7, 28. And in the next, 28 plus 8, 36. And in the next, 36 plus 9. That will give us 45. Next I have taken is question number 2. It says that write the first 5 numbers that can be arranged in dots as rectangles. Now, first 5 numbers that can be arranged in dots. So, first number, according to our notes, is 6, because 6 dots can be arranged like this. After 6, we can take 8 as our next number, because 8 dots can be arranged like this. 4 in the top row and 4 in the bottom row. Now, next we can take is 5 in the top row and 5 in the bottom row. So, next is 10. After 10, the next number we can take is 12. And for 12, we will take 6 dots in the top row and 6 dots in the bottom row. And the next number we can take is 14. And for 14, take 7 dots in the top row and 7 dots in the bottom row. Therefore, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14 are first 5 numbers that can be arranged in dots as rectangles. So, hopefully question number 2 is clear to you. Now, next I have taken is question number 3. And question number 3 says that write the first 6 numbers that can be arranged in dots as squares. And the first number I have taken is 4, because 4 can be arranged as 2 dots in the top row and 2 dots in the bottom row. Also, 4 is a square of 2. That means 2 multiply by 2. Now, second number I can take here is 9. Why 9? Because 9 is a square of 3, and square of 3 means 3 into 3, and 3 into 3 means 9. And how to arrange this? 3 dots in the top row, 3 dots in the middle row and 3 dots in the bottom row. Next number will be 16. And how to arrange? 4 dots in the top row, 4 dots in the second row, 4 dots in the third row and 4 dots in the last row. Okay, so also 16 is a square of 4. Next will be square of 5. Square of 5 means 5 into 5, that is 25. Next will be square of 6, and square of 6 is 6 into 6, that is 36. And the last will be 7 square, that means 7 into 7, 7 sevens are 49. Therefore, 4, 9, 16 and 25, 36 and 49 are the first 6 numbers that can be arranged in dots as squares. So, after understanding today's work, I hope you will be able to do the home task attached in the PDF form in description. For any doubts and queries, you can leave your message in comment section. I hope you like the video. Thank you.